हेलो गाइस, इन दिस वीडियो वी विल टॉक अबाउट कैरेक्टर एरे। सो फर्स्ट वी लुक द डिक्लेरेशन ऑफ द कैरेक्टर एरे। सो आई हैव डिक्लेयर्ड अ कैरेक्टर एरे लाइक दिस, गिव दिस एज 10, देन एट द पोजिशन ऑफ 0 आई हैव इनिशलाइज्ड विद पी, देन आर, देन ए, देन एफ, देन यू, देन एल। ओके, सो इन द मेमोरी सपोज द कैरेक्टर एरे इज स्टोर्ड लाइक दिस, एट द पोजिशन 100 पी इज स्टोर्ड, देन आर, देन ए, देन एफ, देन यू, देन एल। सो लुक, द टोटल साइज ऑफ द कैरेक्टर एरे इज 10. So four positions should be blank in the memory. So I have written the same in the program and look for the output. Give the size of the array 10, then initialized with this, then I print the array. So look for the output. So after Praful, it is giving us some garbage value. Why this garbage value? So garbage value is for these four blanks. It doesn't know where to stop the string. So to identify the our character array is ended, we should mark the last character with null. So we initialize the null character like this. So it will know that this is the last character. So when I add null character in it, then I print, then it will only print Praful, because in C++ strings are terminated by null character. It will ignore the null character, but it will identify that the string is ended. Okay, so now look the length of this string. The character array size 10, but look for the length of a string. So it is giving us the length 6. It will not include the null character in the string, but the null character will always take the space in the memory. So it is occupying 7 bytes of memory for initialization of this array, and the length of a string is 6. Now it should be clear to you, and now we will look more method for initializing a character array. So we can also initialize a character array like this. I have created a character array C, then directly put the string Praful here. Now look the length of the string and also the size of the array. Okay, so we'll also we will look size of C. Okay, so it is giving the length of a string is 6 and size of array is 7. Why 7? I have already told that one extra space for null character, but it will not consider in the length. Okay, now another way of initializing a character array, we can also initialize the character array like this. In the braces we will initialize the character array like this. I am giving here the last character is null to stop the string, but if I do not give it, then what will it do? It will implicitly add this null character if I initialize like this, also for the previous method. So now look for the output. The length of a string is 6 and the size of array is 7, same result, because it will implicitly automatically add the null character if we initialize like this. Also in the previous method, if we see, it is implicitly adding the null character to it. Okay, so only it is printing Praful. So now it should be clear to you how to initialize the character array and all things about character array. In the next video we will talk about the pointers to character array. Thanks for this.